but our compassion has kept us human.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
It has been both our bane of our existence, but it has been what has kept us human. And the thing about it is this creature does not. Remember, his interface with us, his savagery, his bestiality, we civilized him in our suffering. He learned more from us than he learned from him.
That's right.
And that he is now civilized and walking upright because of his interaction with us. He is going to disappear because according to the Nubian agenda, which came out about maybe 20 years ago, and there were four aspects to the Nubian agenda. If one of the codes in the Nubian agenda is cosmically, if your strain of DNA, if your particular consciousness was responsible for any form of genocide of life on this planet, that your strain is due for extinction in the cosmic repertoire of life. So in other words, the Japanese, the whites, anybody who participated in destroying any of the creator's work to the point where they created genocide or was trying to extinct any force of life, know that your karmic signature is to fill that void that you created by your disappearance from all of life. And he is disappearing now because guess what? Now that they took a look at his birth rate, you look at his birth rate back in 1996, it hit below zero. It is minus zero now. So his population growth is minus zero around the world. 50 to 75 more years, he is going to be in the serious minority. That's why he's in Africa right now. That's why he's trying to amalgamate his genes with the Nubian genes so that he could definitely find that doorway, because he's not going to go through that doorway with us 2012. No matter what it is, he may feel something about it. He may be able to explain around it, but he will not be participating in it. So he needs to be mixing with the genes in order to be able to tap into the right frequency to be able to go through that door. Trust me.
And to build on what you just built on is one of the main reasons why I'm coming forth and I'm trying to bring this information to my brothers and sisters, because I'm doing it out of love and I'm doing it because I want them to save their souls before they...
I'm not trying to cut y'all off, right? Hold on. Remember, Brother Phil, you say watch the YouTube video, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If you pause the goddamn thing, right, on the line, you ain't lying. Because they got the time running, right?
Yep.
They mark him a 9.4, and he passed the finish line.
Way past the finish line.
Way
at 9.4.
Go. I'm telling you, go to YouTube, right, and you can pause it. Down the bottom, that's crazy. That is crazy.
It's crazy.
They
robbed the boy, and I saw it.
Yep, it's a 9.4, and he's past the finish line.
That's
wow.
Right.
Yeah. Wow.
The boy who did it with it. And remember, the first time he broke the record, he started playing 10 yards before he crossed the finish line.
Yeah, he did.
Remember the boy started playing around?
He started running across,
and he broke it while he was messing around across the finish line.
That's right.
Wow.
And I said, that boy was to sit down and say, I'm going to run this shit all out, not jiving.
Wow.
I said, that boy's going to smash the record. And guess what? Bang, he ran and he wasn't playing, because every time he runs against Gay, he can't play around. Because Gay is a bastard.
Gay ran a 9.4.
Yeah, Gay is the one who ran the 9.4. That's what I'm saying. That's the fastest race. Ran
ever.
By any man on the planet, and won the white boy in that race.
Won the white boy in the race. So, not a white boy, no way. You know what? They definitely trying to figure out what they're going to do with us, because nature. And you know what? when you start to study DNA and genetics, right? People tend to think because we mix and all that our DNA is coming together, and that's not scientifically true. We're actually splitting away from each other.
Yeah. Well, we are definitely sectioning out.
We're splitting away from them. DNA, right? DNA is smart, right? And it's separating us from them. And that's
it knows where to go to get its strength. That's what it is. And they send that melanin molecule.
But you know what, though, Sister Nikki, I want to bring you into this on what Unc is talking about. In 1976, they did some studies, and they came up with, when it comes to the DNA, and they recognized what they call the mtDNA,
mm-hmm.
which is a separate strain. Listen to me. It's called the mtDNA, and it's only found in females. It's not found in males. And they took placentas from black women, Americans, from white women, from Asian women, and from white women, and looked at and then looked at their mtDNA and found that all of them had come from the black woman.
That's right. Mitochondria, what they call it, the mitochondrial seed.
No man has, men don't have that. That's females have that.
Yeah, but that's the female. She carries the records.
And that's how they can tell. That's the truth to tell about where we really come from, about a female, not about a male.
But wait a minute now. Here's the other part of it. They didn't let you know also that when they put out the DNA and they began to deal with the genome project. They began to take the strands of 3/4 of the world's population and found out that in the black man and woman in Africa, especially the Sudanese area, there were 9 strands connected.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when they go down and they start doing in the lower animals, you got 3 or 4 strands. Then you got the 4 strands in the I believe it was the hippo, the horse, and so forth. Then you go up to 6 strands, and that's the monkey. Then you go up to 9 strands, and that's the original human.
That's right.
The white man in this planet has the 6 strands.
They got exhibit now. They got exhibit in New York.
Now, so when they found that out, that had to be hushed. When they found out that the Sudanese were the ones that were carrying the 9-strand DNA, getting ready to be knitted into the 12, you know what's been happening with the brothers and sisters in Sudan of late?
Genocide.
They've been
genocide.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
They have exactly. For the sister Lucy, where they're dealing with this, it's right on 42nd Street. So you know the exact address where they do the where they're doing the Lucy exhibit.
They're doing a Lucy exhibit in New York.
It's a big thing off of Broadway, and they're posing the questions.
Wow.
Yeah, state of the art. They're going
state
there.
Of the art.
Oh, I gotta go. I gotta get on the plane. I gotta get on the plane and come then. I gotta see this.
Yeah, you gotta see that.
Doc,
I wanna ask you a question, right?
The
right
the mother of creation.
They'll probably come out there to California too.
I'm sitting here looking at this brother run a 9-2. That's crazy.
I wanna ask you a question based on what you said earlier.
Wow.
You were talking about the Nubian codes.
Yeah, the DNA code. 9 strands.
You were talking about
the Nubian agenda.
Right.
The Nubian agenda, where you were saying that come 2012, there's going to be basically a time when if you're resonating on a certain energy, if you're resonating to a certain vibration, you will basically be able to cross through, and if you're not, then you're not going to be able to make it. My question to you is, so understanding what I'm trying to say with this frequency and this code that they're giving our people in the forms of the American Gangster label, which basically encompasses the whole hip, you know, basically what my generation is going through right now, where we're beginning, where we're identifying with the frequency that's basically anchored in lower self.
Right.
Right? So if the majority of the people are resonating on this frequency that we'll find our enemy resonating on, is it safe to say that these brothers will get caught up in the trap also?
Well, see, that's why I have been so adamant about brothers and sisters preparing themselves for that quickening. The quickening can only happen when, first and foremost, that you're focused. Your attention is not on judgment. It's not about fear. It's not about worrying whether or not you can or cannot. You have to affirm that whatever it is that you are attempting to achieve, you have already achieved it. Mm-hmm. See, that's the thing. The way that the mind is going to be quickened when we pass that gate is that it's going to be about spontaneous manifestation of your thoughts and your will.
Mm-hmm.
So they understand that the population is going to be very adamant, and if you're not making sure that the population is either completely suppressed or completely sedated, which is why we have to go through this vaccination program over the next 3 years, to completely destroy and to numb the frequencies in the blood, because the blood is where all of that action program over the next 3 years, to completely destroy and to numb the frequencies in the blood, because the blood is where all of that action for evolution and consciousness happens. If your blood cells ain't working, then you can't channel or broadcast consciousness through your consciousness in your brain, because they're shutting down the stations that that consciousness needs to factor in order to be able to be broadcasted.
Absolutely.
So when your cells are depreciated and you cannot take in or vibrate the light codes, you can't participate in what the universe wants its creations to participate in as far as consciousness is concerned. So what you do to prepare is to make sure that you are not taking in any poisons that are going to be depreciating your cellular nervous system, the nervous system especially. You got to eat the right foods. There's certain things you could take, like what Queen and I found, something called Juice Plus, which is nothing but juice, vegetables, or fruits, vegetables, and juice. It ain't got nothing else except that. You got to be taking in stuff that's going to help repair your DNA faster than the foods that you're eating. You can't be going to Mickey D's. You can't be drinking the Coca-Colas or the Sprites. You can't be dropping 40s and thinking that when you go through that nexus that somehow you're going to be enlightened. Yeah, you're going to be quickened, but you're going to be quickened at the level that you're participating in.
Yep.
So if you're quickened at this level where you're talking gangster, then, yeah, you're going to be more gangster than you were before. The repercussions for that will be more immediate. So what you're going to be doing now as we are channeling this, this is just the beginning. We're talking about the transit between 12 and 20. That's going to be where we're going to see the mass destruction. And that's where you're noticing, family, that all the movies coming out now are all about Armageddon. There's no hope. Everything is about
all destruction
of everything on the planet. They're getting your mind conditioned for Armageddon. And
hey,
this 2012 that's coming up, you got to see it, man. You're talking about cinematography where there's no hope. Everybody going to think they're going to jump in their cellars or they got a bunker. Ain't nothing going to be around. The whole earth is turning over. The continent is turning upside down.
Brother, I understand that
you have to prepare yourself by deleting all things that are going to weaken you physically, psychologically, spiritually. And physically is the anchor to all your psychology, and your psychology is the anchor to your spirituality.
Yep.
So can it be safe to say that being that knowledge is power, right? Would it be safe to say that it's inherent that we begin in taking all of this this knowledge this afford to us?
Well, the knowledge is not the power. It's what you extract from knowledge that works
is
the power.
It's the wisdom. Yeah. It's
right.
The
wisdom is
of the knowledge.
Right.
Yeah.
So what you have to do very quickly, and this is why discernment, spiritual discernment is so powerful, is in this time, you ain't got no time to be processing the knowledge. This is why they have bum-rushed all the knowledge into your consciousness. You can go there and any place now, and they just overload you and flood you with so much knowledge, you ain't got no time to read it. What you got to do is get the basics of everything that you're learning right now and trust your spirituality to guide you from there. Not to say that you're just going to go into a hoodoo space and just go into home and then start thinking that you're going to catch on to information from out of the air, even though that's where we're headed. But your discernment has to be open. You cannot be inebriated. You can't be smoking cigarettes. You can't be drinking 40s. You can't be doing any of those things that's going to impair your physicality so that your psychology is working correctly. And when your psychology is working correctly, your spirituality is honing in correctly. So all these things must be taken into consideration, and your everyday matter-of-fact habits have to be put into check.
Can I share something, brother? I don't want to disagree with anything that you said, because I agree with you, but my reading on 2012 and what I'm feeling and what I'm seeing and what I'm hearing is a little bit different, just a little bit different. It's about consciousness, and it is about spirit, but it's about the awakening of the so-called junk DNA that is in our cells. That's what it's about. It's about when 2012 comes, when the Earth passes through the galactic core, which is where where all of us came from, where our galaxy came from. There is going to be an opening up and an awareness of the DNA that is already within us.
Yeah, but again, the DNA only keeps information from the DNA you begin with.
No, and what we're going to be able to do from the creators who already put that DNA in us, that you just finished talking about the different strands. That's why I said that's why those strands are important for who has those strands and who doesn't. Because who has those strands are going to be moving in a direction toward the light. Those
right.
who don't have that strand are going to be moving in the direction toward control. So
right.
when we move through this galactic, when the Earth moves through this galactic core, and our DNA wakes up, because at the end of all of our cells and our DNA is pure space and light. And that is the light. That is the light, and that comes from the universe, from our galaxy, the intelligence, the spiritual cosmic intelligence that governs everything. We're
right.
going to wake up, and when we wake up, what's going to happen is the world that we know is no longer going to exist. The connection between our conscious mind and our subconscious mind is going to be gone. There's not going to be a conscious and a self-conscious. It's going to be one conscious. And our ability to travel, we're gonna be able to leave our bodies. We're gonna be able to travel without planes, without cars. We're gonna be able to feel each other.
Yeah.
We're gonna become empathic. We're gonna be able to
that's
communicate
amazing.
With each other telepathically. We're gonna be able to feel each other's pain. See, that's why it's important.
Yeah.
That's why it's important what you were saying about where your consciousness is. Because if you come from a place of destruction, you come from a place of control. Then you're going to vibrate at that level, so you're going to feel everybody else. And that's why you were saying, if you angry and you pissed off and you want to be about war, you're going to be more about war than you ever have been, and your destruction and your demise is going to come about quicker than it ever has
that's
been.
That's it.
Either.
But again, the core is, everything you're saying is absolutely correct. The core, however, is the quickening will not happen. Your DNA will not respond if you have been poisoned. That's the secret. The secret to understanding that the light codes are the universal intelligence matrix broadcasting the next set of your instructions for consciousness evolution, I understand that. But
yeah.
you have to talk to people at the level they're on right now. People identify immediately with what it is that they do every day by habit. And food is a habit. Food is an addiction right now. So what we have to understand is that the way that that universal intelligence matrix connects to us is through the food we eat. If we eat the proper foods that are the organic fruits made by our nature, the nature. Nature itself is the vibratory tuning fork that gives us information through the fruits that we eat, which then imparts that secondhand to the information of the DNA. So if we do not anchor our physiology, we will not anchor the psychology that will then interpret what the spirituality is giving to us. So we have
right.
to first take it in small baby steps. Everything you're saying is definitely profound and true, but it's for those on the PhD level you're speaking to. We have to speak to the people who we want to be able to participate, and so we have to make it very simple for them so that the average man and woman can get to work so that they can participate in that quickening when they do go through. Not the galactic core, but a galactic gate, which is
right.
actually the Milky Way. They're not going through the galactic core. They're going around
right.
the galactic core, but not through the galactic core.
Right. Joseph,
no,
pass
through it, not through it that way. Yeah,
Joseph,
I agree with that,
remember,
brother. I appreciate that.
Do you remember when I did the show? Like, I did the show, 2 weeks ago on, you know, cleaning up the physical in order to vibrate on a higher frequency, and that's exactly what I was talking about.
Right.
The
right.
food you
well,
eat,
so you
getting
know,
rid of smoking, all the habits you got, you start eating fresh foods. I talked about all of that.
You know what? What's so funny? What's so beautiful? And I love the fact that the brother, tell me your name again. I'm sorry, so I can address you by your name. The older
Which
gentleman.
One are you talking to? Me?
The gentleman.
I'm Dr. Valentine.
Dr. Valentine, I appreciate you because I love what you said, and I appreciate you telling me and saying it that way for me to lower, because I do, you know, a lot of times I just, because, see, I don't have those things in my life. You know, I eat properly. I don't drink and smoke and do all that stuff, and you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. A lot of times I forget, you know, sometimes.
Yes.
You're
talking
right.
to the average brothers and sisters
yeah.
out there. You see, that's what I'm saying. I don't want to go too far from them. We know the brothers and sisters in this circle know exactly what you mean. We can't estrange our brothers and sisters who are just learning, you see.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
Yeah, well, you catch your breath.
Yeah.
Goodness.
Are you still here? Are you still here for a moment? We didn't just took over your little show. I'm sorry.
You ain't lying.
No, y'all contributing to this historic show, and I'm highly honored by everybody that's on this line contributing to this conversation that we're having. You know what I mean?
Now one superhero, we brought forth the superheroes.
That's right.
Yeah, I'm basically showing, proving what it is that I'm saying, that we're here. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? That we're here. We don't have to look outside of ourselves. It's all right here.